Aloha, everyone. It's Paul Aker here with the Real Estate Investors Resource. And this week, we're talking about lemons and how to avoid them when you're buying vacation rental property. Hit the music. So I'm trying to show you how to keep from getting squeezed on your vacation rental purchase. And I'm not talking about the obvious things like property inspections and things like that. No, I'm going to show you how to look under the hood of the property's financial condition and figure out what's going on there and whether this is a good buy. For vacation rental buyers, there are two big things that you need to do. One of them is to request the books, and the second is to see the reserve study and do a reserve study analysis. These are critical steps, and timing is important here, so pay close attention. If you're buying a vacation rental property, you have every right to request what are called the books. This is the profit and loss statement, basically how much money the property has made or lost in the past several years, if it's been operating as a vacation rental property that long, and a full accounting of all the expenses, everything from cleaning to management to all the things that go into owning and operating, maybe maintenance fees. All those things should be listed out in a column, and then all the income in another column. And obviously at the bottom, you find out, hey, did this thing make money? If so, how much? And you need to pay close attention to that. And a note here, you want to see a property that's doing well, but if it's not performing up to your expectations, that's not always a bad sign. It can be a flag, and you should pay attention to it as a flag, but it might also be an opportunity for you. You might be able to make money on the property when you get a hold of it and start operating it and make some of the tweaks that you've noticed in the property that could help you generate income. Obviously, that's a sophisticated analysis and you need to pay attention. You don't want to go into a property that's underperforming and just hope and guess that you might be able to make it work better. Get my book, Profits in Paradise. That will help you figure that out. We lay all the strategies out there and that will help you find those, identify those ways to improve on the property's performance. But the point here is to get the books and get them right away. Now, timing can be a little bit tricky. Sometimes you want to get them, before you make the offer or right after. Definitely, it depends on the market conditions. You want to work that out with your realtor to figure out what's the best play in your particular situation. But get them and get them as soon as possible. Take a look at those documents and figure out what the profit and loss on the property is, as well as the occupancy rate. Those books should include how high the occupancy rate has been in at least the past year, hopefully the last 2 or 3 years. Take a look at that. That will tell you a lot as well. Again, Profits in Paradise goes into a lot of that. The next thing is something called a reserve study. This tells you how much a condo has in essentially its savings account waiting for a rainy day. And when we're talking about rainy day, really what this is in a condo situation or an association situation, you have two accounts typically. One is the operating account over here. The other is the reserve account over here. This is more like the savings account, backup money for when things go wrong, like a roof needs to be repaired, maybe pavement needs to be resurfaced. That's what this pot of money is for. So you need to take a look and see A, how much is in the pot of money, and B, whether that's enough to cover those expenses that are forecasted in the reserve study. So a good reserve study is going to tell you when that roof is going to need repaired or when that pavement is going to need sealed, and if you're counting or collecting enough money to keep up with that. Unfortunately, a lot of those complexes out there don't have up-to-date reserve studies. It doesn't do you really much good if you don't have a reserve study that's not at least 2 or 3 years since it was published. You don't want anything too much older than that because it just doesn't do you much in the way of accurately predicting what's going to happen to the property. So if you're looking for a reserve study and they don't have one, don't have a recent one, big red flags. If you're seeing problems there in terms of the amount that it's collecting, you want to pay close attention to that, because if it's not collecting enough, you're going to have what's called a special assessment. That is when these guys, the chickens, come home to roost. Can you hear them? That's right. They come home to roost financially. You're not paying now, you're going to pay later. And how you make up for that in the special assessment is a big whopping bill that's assessed to the owners, and they're going to have to come up with the money. A lot of times it's more than the actual maintenance fee each month. And unfortunately for some people, that means that they have to go into debt, or they have to sell at a much lower rate price than they'd like to. A lot of issues go along with that special assessment. Avoid those. Take a look at the a reserve study, do a reserve study analysis. If you need help here, help is on the way. Go ahead and click the link. You're going to find Fee Factors. That's down there in the description link. Fee Factors, it's a free ebook that I created that's there just to help you walk through analyzing the reserve study, what amounts are right, which amounts are not. Be a great aid to you. So hopefully with all this information, we're going to help you avoid the lemon. Avoid those vacation rental lemons. Listen to the music and remember Profits in Paradise, Fee Factors. You can find Profits in Paradise on Amazon. Fee Factors free right here. Until next time, I'm Paul Aker with the Real Estate Investors Resource. Thank you.